go.
Who wants to pretend their hand is a gun? What is this, third grade?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jack Tretton.
Wow. Wow. Check out this stage. I feel like I'm at a U2 concert. And it's not intimidating enough to be in front of a big crowd. We gotta be in the crowd. And I gotta warn you guys, there's gonna be a lot of action, a lot of great product, and other than a little spittle from me, your only risk. So no need for ponchos, we're gonna do it natural. So. I saw the big round of applause for Kevin Butler in the video, and I know a lot of our fans and the blog suggested how cool it would be if maybe Kevin Butler co-hosted with me, and I gotta be honest with you, definitely considered it for a minute, but the guy's already got a 50-foot mural in front of the convention center, and he's stealing all my ink, so I'm sorry. It's all about me for a couple minutes. Thank you. On behalf of everyone at PlayStation, I wanna welcome you back to the historic Shrine Auditorium. We've come to E3 with momentum on our side. We just passed 10 consecutive months of year-over-year growth, and we're just beginning to hit our stride. 4 years ago, we came to E3 and we announced a new 10-year vision for home entertainment. We said we'd build an ecosystem of content and services that matched our heritage. This vision was of a home entertainment device, one that was future-proof and constantly evolving. We said that this device would transition Sony Computer Entertainment into more than a gaming company. It would transition us into an interactive networked entertainment company. In less than 4 years into this life cycle, we're living that vision. PlayStation 3 is the only console with something for every single member of your family. It's the only console with Blu-ray, built-in Wi-Fi, integrated hard drives in every unit, and a free and growing portfolio of network services. Along the way, we've been continually introducing unrivaled gaming experiences that you've come to expect from PlayStation, with franchises like God of War, Heavy Rain, Little Big Planet, SOCOM, and Uncharted. And these are exclusive games you can only experience on PS3. But at PlayStation, we're not simply focused on introducing great new games and hardware technology. Consumers can enjoy virtually any form of entertainment experience on the PS3 and the PlayStation Network. It's not just confined to your living room. You can take it with you anywhere on the go. For 15 years, we've strived to create an experience that's both dazzling and transformative. And consumers want all their games, music, photos, movies, and TV shows accessible in one place from one device. And PlayStation has the most capable and connected platform on the planet. We'd like to share our vision of the future, one that we see clearly in high-definition 3D. I'd like to bring out our first guest of the afternoon, the president and group CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment and president of Sony's Network Products and Services Group, Kaz Sarai.
Thank you, Jack. He took all my good lines, so I'm just going to go right into the teleprompter, I guess. It's great to be back here on stage at E3 again. Always a pleasure seeing everybody. Wanted to speak a little bit about 3D today. So PlayStation's heritage and legacy has always been centered on two tenets that we have that the whole family can enjoy. First, it's about all innovation. And then second, it's all about content. And in the next year, PlayStation will take both its innovation as well as its content to a completely new level. And from the camera to all the way to the living room, Sony is the undisputed leader in 3D. We're the only company that provides an end-to-end ecosystem of that 3D experience. Sony innovation drove the whole industry to Blu-ray, and what PlayStation did for Blu-ray, we're now ready to do it for 3D as well. It's that experience and content that will define 3D. And PlayStation 3 enables users to enjoy the true 3D experience in the home, and it's really the perfect vehicle for 3D distribution, delivery, and of course, entertainment content. Sony Bravia 3D-ready TVs are being shipped out as we speak, and they are arriving in homes across the world. And we will already have built in an install base of more than 35 million PS3s that are 3D-ready. We have enabled every PS3 through a system software update to be your 3D entertainment hub and to drive your 3D entertainment. Titles such as Super Stardust, Pain, MotorStorm Pacific Rift, and of course, Wipeout HD. They are all downloadable from the PlayStation Store in 3D today, with 20 titles created natively in 3D coming by the end of March 2011. A decade from now, when we look back at this year, 2010, it will most likely be remembered as the year that PlayStation brought authentic 3D to the industry, creating new experiences for gamers and families, and new business lines for retailers, and of course, our publishing partners. It's a whole other dimension for PS3 and for the industry. And there is no place where 3D is more defined than with PlayStation 3. Now, to demonstrate one of the industry's most anticipated 3D titles, Killzone 3, here from Guerrilla Games is Herman Hulst.
Thank you, everyone. We are very excited to be here today to present this live demo of Killzone 3 in 3D. 3D technology is not something we're looking to merely adapt into Killzone 3. Rather, 3D is a key pillar in our development process, and we are creating Killzone 3 with complete 3D integration in mind, so from the ground up. Killzone 3 is easily our most ambitious project to date, and we're very excited to show you some of our latest single-player campaign. We will demo two separate sections from the fourth level of the game. The scene is set in the Arctic north of the planet Helgan, and this is just one of a variety of unique environments that Killzone 3 will deliver. Now, as you'll see, players will have access to dynamic new weapons and vehicle gameplay, facing tougher and scarier enemies than ever before. The goal is to put you in the middle of a very realistic sci-fi war, where a sense of immersion is brought to life with stunning visuals, with robust audio effects, and of course, the ability to play in 3D. Now, since time is limited, we want to get straight into the action, so please welcome our producer, Steven Terheide. Put on your 3D glasses, enjoy the demo of Killzone 3, and bear in mind, this is a live demo that consists of two sections. Enjoy.
Straight and run around this. Boom, baby.
Nice work, people!
Naval. All Raiders, prepare to move topside. I want all fire on that.
Raider Command, we got some dropships on the pad up here.
I don't see them.
Command, they're at your 12. Circle around.
Raider 3, I want positive ID on those dropships.
Not our bird, sir. Narvel's long gone. We're wasting our
command. We got a fast mover on radar.
It's on my tail. I need assistance.
All call signs. Break off and assist Raider 3. We're in pursuit of the dropship.
Incoming missile fire. Taking evasive. Christ.
Thank you, Steven. Killzone 3 is a technical showpiece with truly epic cinematic moments and explosive set pieces, all coming together to deliver the most realistic sci-fi shooter experience available. I am happy to announce that Killzone 3 will be available worldwide this coming February 2011, exclusively on PlayStation 3. Another piece of news I'm pleased to share is that Killzone 3 will be fully compatible with PlayStation Move functionality at launch. And we'll be talking more about that, obviously, in the months to come. Now, to see more of this level, as well as 3D gameplay, please come by at the SCA booth and experience it for yourself. Thank you for now, and I hope you guys enjoy the show.
Thanks, Herman. How about that for an immersive 3D experience? How about another round of applause for Herman and the guys from Guerrilla Games? Yeah. Now, like any new form of entertainment technology, the content drives the consumer interest and, of course, the adoption as well. And what titles like Avatar are doing for 3D movies, titles like Killzone 3 will do for 3D games. This isn't content that was merely adapted for 3D. It was created for 3D. Only games developed for 3D can provide the true 3D gaming experience. And this is the only place you will see it because PS3 is the only platform with native 3D gaming. Some of our biggest titles on PS3 this year will be in 3D, including MotorStorm Apocalypse, Killzone 3, and the Sly Collection. And just wait till you look over the hood as you barrel through the city in Gran Turismo 5 in 3D. Yeah. In addition, our publishing partners are bringing some of the industry's biggest franchise to everyone in 3D as well, including titles like Crysis 2 from Electronic Arts, Mortal Kombat from Warner Brothers, Ubisoft's Shaun White Skateboarding, Ghost Recon Future Soldier, Tron Evolution, the video game from Disney, and NBA 2K11 from 2K Sports. Finally, when you pair 3D with the upcoming PlayStation Move, the experience is unlike anything you've ever seen before. Titles like The Fight, Lights Out, iPet, Tumble, and MLB The Show. They will all take advantage of both PlayStation Move as well as 3D, and it's really the closest thing you will ever experience to being physically in the game itself. Now, we have one last 3D video to show you today, to really show you that it's not just a future of entertainment, it's a future that Sony will lead. So, everybody, put your glasses back on and take a look at the video. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
What you just saw is one more leap in the entertainment experience, moving us closer to a more immersive, more realistic gaming environment. That's good news for every single person in this room. Our industry is often caught talking in terms of life cycles, but things have changed. It's no longer simply a question of how long you can be relevant in people's lives, but in how many ways you can be relevant in people's lives. This year not only represents the 15th anniversary of PlayStation, but we're also celebrating the 10th anniversary of the PlayStation 2. This is an incredible testament to both the technology and the software, but also the consumer support over the last decade. And we're not slowing down. According to Nielsen, PlayStation 2 was the second most played console last year, and we sold 7.3 million units globally. PlayStation 2 continues to provide value to publishers, retailers, and consumers, and we expect another strong year in North America with continued growth and expansion in Latin America. At PlayStation, our innovation has always been focused on creating entirely new experiences. With the PlayStation 3, we're reaching out to non-gamers, but we're also honoring the core gamers by championing their other forms of entertainment, all under one roof and with one investment. Since last year, we've had a huge influx of consumers going out and buying the PS3. And they're also connecting it. And they're not just connecting it for the great head-to-head gaming experiences, but also for the more than 3,400 movies and 20,000 television episodes. They're connecting their PS3s to stream Netflix, browse the internet, or to stream music from any room in their house. It's not necessarily because consumers are more tech-savvy. It's because they're appreciating all the ways it connects to their lives, and they recognize and appreciate the added value in services. Another breakthrough that will enable brand new experiences is an innovation that we unveiled at GDC 3 months ago. A new product that won't just allow consumers to enjoy the games or be surrounded by the game, but literally to move into the game. You really have to get involved, and that is a major shift in motion gaming. The difference comes down to one word: realism. The PlayStation Move difference is the ability to precisely replicate every subtlety in that motion. How it happens in your hand is how it happens on the screen. Here to tell us a bit more about it, please welcome Peter Dilley.
Thanks, Jack. Great job. And thanks to all of you here at E3. It's very exciting to be here at E3 with so much momentum behind the PlayStation 3 platform. You know, at PlayStation, we've always been focused on innovation that drives our category forward, and PlayStation Move does it again. We often describe PlayStation 3 as another future-proof PlayStation product. And here we are, nearly 4 years into the life cycle, and PlayStation 3 is defining and introducing leading-edge technology with 3D and now with PlayStation Move. The entertainment solution that only does everything now does even more. Of course, PlayStation Move will offer great casual and family games. But PlayStation Move also introduces a new level of precision that allows us to create new gaming experiences that won't just appeal to casual fans, but will appeal to core gamers as well. Really, for the first time in motion gaming, core gamers will have something they'll find both challenging and rewarding. So how does PlayStation Move work, and what makes it special? It's really the combination of the PlayStation Eye camera and the Move controller that gives you unrivaled one-to-one tracking. And it's this fidelity and precision that changes everything. The Move controller has three sensors built in that provide motion and pointing data directly to the cell processor on board the PS3. And in addition, the light emitted from the Move controller is tracked by the PlayStation Eye camera in real time to give the exact location of the controller in 3D space. Now, this unrivaled precision in motion gaming makes the gaming experience better for anybody, whether you're a casual gamer or a hardcore gamer. The industry's best development studios have raved that the data they get back from the controller is exactly what they're looking for, and it frees their teams up to focus on the fun aspects of the game without worrying about some of the limitations they might find on other hardware systems. So what does the development really think about this technology? Let's take a look.
What we're working on is really the next generation of user interface.
No matter how intense the game experience is on a controller or even a mouse and keyboard, the fact that this is suddenly requiring your whole body to move. Now granted, it's your hand, but it can track how high I go, how low I go. So I crouch, it goes down with me. Everything I do matters to this thing.
PS3 motion controller, I would say, is head and shoulders over anything else that's out there for console in terms of versatility.
We can actually detect total one-to-one precision, and then we can detect all your movements.
This is, you know, one-to-one. It's doing exactly what I want.
Not just like this, but this way too. Because real boxers don't hit like this.
When you have this physical interface device that for the first time can start to pull the game out of the TV and into the living room is the first foray into what I really consider next generation gaming.
Getting lost in the character is definitely what the soul of this device is about.
Plus, PlayStation Move's not only crazy precise, it's also got what we in the future call buttons, which turn out to be pretty important to those handful of millions of people who enjoy playing shooters, platformers, or, well, anything that doesn't involve catching a big red ball.
By augmenting reality, by putting you inside the game, that's not the experience you've ever had before.
I think one of the interesting things about that is the diversity of games. Now we've got games for the hardcore, games that are little simulations of combat. We've got games for people that just want to dance in front of a TV, games for people who want to get fit.
We can make games that don't require a lot of explanation anymore. We can really draw people from your family who'd never played games before, or the people who maybe felt that before they were cut off from the rest, you know, from the gaming community, can suddenly join in because the interactions are very, very intuitive.
PlayStation.
Great stuff there. I'd like to thank all of our development partners, but in addition to those key developers, you also saw my good friend and colleague Kevin Butler point out something else kind of important. The PlayStation Move has buttons, which are critical to precision. Now, buttons allow you to have more control over the game and quite simply, again, get the most out of your gaming experience, whether you're a core gamer or a casual gamer. And we're really not trying to stir the pot here, but we think it's an important distinction and a unique advantage to our technology. Now, we know motion gaming is fun. And when you combine motion control with a new level of precision and then see it presented in high definition or maybe even in 3D, you'll start to appreciate that precision even more. But there are other advantages that the PlayStation 3 provides to developers beyond high definition that help out our motion control entry. As you'll see with games from SOCOM 4 to NBA 2K11, with the capacity of Blu-ray, we can put both the traditional game and the PlayStation Move version on the same Blu-ray disc. This provides tremendous value to the consumer. It's really like getting two games in one. And it offers a very compelling model to our publishing partners that helps them minimize their risk. And this has not been lost on them. Since our unveiling at GDC, we have nearly 40 developers and publishing partners working on PlayStation Move products, many of which you'll be able to play at our booth here this week at E3. And at GDC just a few months ago, we showed a variety of games, from Little Big Planet, The Fight Lights Out, and iPet. Now, you can imagine how great these games look today after a few additional months of polish. But we're not here today to show you the same games over again, although we do hope that you'll check them out in our booth. They look fantastic. We have so much great content that I'd like to show you some new games today revealed for the first time anywhere. So, to get us started, I'd like to invite to the stage Christian Busick, the creative director from The Workshop. Christian.
Thanks, Peter. Sorcery is a third-person action-adventure game designed specifically for the PlayStation Move. You play the role of a young sorcerer's apprentice who must brave the nightmarish fairy kingdoms in order to stop a growing evil from engulfing the land in darkness. When we first began to design Sorcery, we were really excited about the new possibilities that were capable with this motion device. Most notably, the grail of development, total sense of immersion, right? So in the demo I'm about to show you here, you're going to see the kind of fidelity of my actions on screen that isn't possible with any other kind of motion controller. So enough talking, let's play some Sorcery.
Not knowing what lay beyond, the young apprentice stepped bravely through a thousand-year-old gateway into the fairy realm, in vain hope of stopping the Nightmare Queen from covering the land in darkness.
Oh,
So as we begin, I want to point out this fidelity motion I was talking about. You'll notice the apprentice leaves his arm in full one-to-one like I'm doing. Targeting is incredibly easy. All you do is just flick at the screen. What is making that noise? All right, that's better. Now, my actions with the wand affect the bolt's power and also trajectory. I have a few other spells, so with a quick press of the button, let's go to frost. Now, once frozen, I can use my arcane bolt to shatter enemies. Now, combining spells is one of the cool features of sorcery. I'll show you some more of that in a moment. That potion looks inviting. Excuse me. Polymorph rat potion. So this will let me take the form of a rat, and it'll help me access areas that I couldn't get to in human form. All right, let's shake this thing up. Who knows how long it's been sitting there. You'll notice the ball changes color to let me know it's ready. Just give it back and drink. So you'll notice now, as a rat, I can access this tunnel, which will take me to an area that was previously inaccessible. Now, other creature forms will open up new types of gameplay and other exploration possibilities. Ah, boy, more goblins. All right, let's try another spell. I also have a whirlwind spell, which allows me to set guys up and move them around the world. You'll notice I can steer the whirlwind with the controller. Uh-oh. Good thing I have my fire. Fire's great for dealing with groups of enemies. I can also use fire to draw a line in front of me, creating a wall of fire that'll keep these guys off me long enough to fire up another world. Sending it through the fire, creating a firestorm. Oh, these guys are never ending. One last thing, I have a powerful area of effect spell I can charge up. Big time spells like that cost a lot of power. If you're not careful, you could find yourself in trouble. Now, magic and sorcery can also be used to alter the environment. This broken bridge here can be repaired with a simple mending spell. Once again, like the rat potion, the mending spell will give me access to areas that I couldn't get to before.
And it would soon be that the apprentice would learn the true power of fairy magic, and that goblins are the least of the horrors beneath the ground.
Thanks, everyone. We're going to have a whole lot more sorcery to show in the future, so I look forward to seeing you soon.
Hey, I'm up here now. This is so Ryan Seacrest. If my daughter could see me, she'd be thrilled. Sorcery is really a great example of how we're going to use the PlayStation Move technology in unique ways, and really a bit of a sneak peek into how we think next-generation motion gaming will look. I think you saw some tremendous examples of a wildly unique user interface that you're just not going to find on any platform, so great job. But next, we'd like to show how PlayStation Move is going to revolutionize your sports gaming experience. Please welcome to the stage the head of worldwide development for EA Sports, Andrew Wilson.
Thanks, Peter. We're really excited about PlayStation Move and for the enhanced authenticity it brings to Tiger Woods PGA Tour. Motion control, as you can imagine, is very important for our Tiger franchise. It perfectly recreates the feeling of swinging your golf club out on the course. When you combine the one-to-one motion of the PlayStation Move with HD visuals on the PS3, the experience is outstanding. So let's jump into the demo here. I'll just grab this and get us calibrated. Wonderful. So we're standing here on the par 4 third hole at Pebble Beach, staged for this year's US Open. What you notice immediately is it's a dogleg left, right to left, which is clearly a practical joke the dev team have played on me because I've been playing golf for 20 years and my stock shot is left to right. So I'm going to try and perform something here in front of a gallery that I've never been able to do in real life. And what we realize about PlayStation Move is we're now all about one-to-one movement. So it's no longer about pre-canned animations. And so when I say to you, this is probably one of the hardest things I have ever done, which is hit a draw in front of, 1,000 people, it could go horribly wrong. So as a precursor to that, I have turned on mulligans, because it may take me a couple to pull this off. The other thing you've heard today is power is important. So it's not about just flicking the wrist. I've really got to perform a golf swing. I'm just gonna change direction there a little bit. I'm gonna take it out around those trees. Like hitting a draw wasn't hard enough. I'm now gonna try and shape it around some trees. I'm gonna set this up here. You see I get feedback there, open the club, shut the club. I'm gonna try and just do this straight up and down. Nice smooth swing. Anyone play golf? They always tell you to swing smoothly and slowly. Get it down towards the ball there. Get it up. Ooh, what'd I tell you? One-to-one movement. Okay. That's not bad, right? Oh, but power count. We didn't see that. My shoulders are limbered up, my hips are open, I am ready to go. Okay, here we go. It's about power now. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. The other thing you get to know about the move is it's about feel. So anyone who's played shots out of a bunker in golf knows that it's all in the wrist, it's all about feel. So I'm gonna try and get green and regulation out of the bunker. This is probably not gonna go very well, but we're gonna try it anyway. So first thing I'm gonna do, open up my stance a little bit. You see, I'm gonna open up my club face. Okay, here we go. Oh, look at that, get on. No. That's okay. We're in the first cut. So a nice little chip on. Again, it's all about feel. You'll be seeing down in that bottom left corner there, every time I do something, I'm getting the feedback as whether I'm hitting a draw or a fade. Okay. Who thinks I can get it up and down in one here? Okay, I've got some support. There we go. Okay, again, open the stance. It's gonna be all about feel. Just gonna take it back nice and slowly. Wasn't bad. All right, I'm gonna try and save par here for you today. The other thing, using the buttons here on the controller, I'm gonna give myself a little putt preview. Oh, that's a little dicey there. I'm gonna give myself a little putt preview that's available for you when you've built up enough focus. So I'm just gonna turn him slightly this way. There we go, we're gonna see if we can't save par here. Again, nice smooth putting stroke. There we go. Get in the hole. And we save par here today. On the par 4, little shaky there at the outset. We all forget about the mulligan, right? So from shaping shots to swinging the golf club to draining a long putt, it's all enhanced by playing Tiger on PlayStation Move. The Move helps us to capture authentic sports motion with a one-to-one swing that you saw here today. And it's all in HD on the PS3. The Move functionality for Tiger will be available via PSN as a downloadable update when the controller ships this fall, and also available as a demo on the Move demo disc. So thanks very much, have a great show, and happy golfing.
Andrew, thanks very much. That was terrific. I hope you can get a sense that that precision doesn't just add to the realism, it also adds the fun factor. But on the point of precision, if you're a golfer, you know that getting that club face square is actually a big part of hitting the ball straight. And I've told Andrew, if this actually helps me get my score down, my handicap down to single digits, we'll have a steady stream of co-marketing dollars going to EA's way. So now, Tiger is a very important franchise for PlayStation 3 and a great example of how key franchises play a big role in the content lineup for PlayStation Move. One final title I'd like to introduce today builds on our strong heritage of our brand and the familiar faces you've come to associate with PlayStation. It's a game created solely for PlayStation Move for the millions of fans of our most recognizable characters. I'm pleased to introduce today Heroes on the Move.
When great heroes assemble, there unfolds a brilliant pageant of poise and grace. But not with these heroes. Now, together for the first time, Ratchet, Jack, Sly Cooper, Bentley, Clay, and Daxter. Six heroes, completely out of control, until now. You'll be the one delivering every clutch and hurling every weapon. Only with PlayStation Move, six big heroes, one epic showdown.
Thank you. Hope you can get the sense. We're going to have games representing virtually every genre and appealing to every gamer, from core gamers to moms and families, and from fitness junkies to HD enthusiasts. So with an opportunity so big, we needed a marketing campaign that would get the word out to everybody. And we've got one coming. One company that really wanted to be a part of that story and help us tell the story was Coca-Cola. Now, Coke has supported active and positive living for almost 125 years. And through our partnership with Coca-Cola later this year and throughout the holiday season, more than 130 million packages of Coca-Cola products will highlight PlayStation Move and PS3. Consumers everywhere will have a chance to win PlayStation Move and PS3, as well as great games like Sports Champions, EA Active, NBA 2K11, and Tron Evolution, the video game. Now, each of these games will be featured on those 130 million packages of Coke, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, and Sprite. And this is going to be one of the biggest brand partnerships we've ever had. So keep your eye out this fall for PlayStation Move in your grocery store and wherever Coca-Cola products are sold.
Peter, you look like you could use a Coke.
Kev, you know, there was a rumor you were going to show up.
Peter, you can't believe everything you read on the internet.
You don't have to tell me.
Listen, I'm sorry about this, but as long as I'm here, do you mind if I get something off my chest?
I'm kind of in the middle of something here, Kev.
I'll be quick. So am I crazy, or did I just see 100 French acrobats prancing around an arena the other night? I hear there was a sale on blue ponchos. But seriously, I know everyone's got their eye on this motion control battle like it was Olivia Munn and a Lara Croft outfit. I say it's time we focus on what really matters. The games. Who's with me? See, I love gaming. Okay? I love you too. I love walk-off homers and headshots. I love drifting a turn at 100 miles an hour in boss battles with a 600-foot-tall Greek god who may or may not be your father. Gaming is having a ridiculously huge TV in a tiny one-room apartment. Staying up till 3 a.m. to earn a trophy that isn't real. But is. And it's girls who know that the way to a man's heart is through a melee attack. I love gaming. And I know you love it too. That's why you're here. And why millions of people are pretending to work while they watch this at their desk. It's why we made the PlayStation Move. So every person on this great spinning marble will be able to get a taste of the PS3 sugar. Families, kids, grandparents, and you hardcore guys, I'm talking about you. Don't hate on them. Don't do it. Look at it this way. If you've got an awesome girlfriend, and then someone else gets an awesome girlfriend, do you know who wins? Everyone. With PlayStation Move, your mom can make your mom jokes after she takes you to school in table tennis. And a 10-year-old kid in Fresno can make a frat boy in Boston question his own manhood. And we can all box using game characters that have important features, like arms. And necks. When we said the PS3 only does everything, we meant it. And the move brings a whole lot more everything to the table. Because every gamer is a true gamer. Motion gamers, sitting gamers, everyone. And though we may pledge fanboy allegiances to different flags, deep down inside we all serve one master, one king. And his name is Gaming. Forever may he reign!
Kevin, that was epic.
Thank you, Pete.
Listen, you want to stick around, help me wrap this up?
I'd love to. I just got word that Jack needs a Coke backstage.
All right, get on it. Hey, don't forget the lemon.
I never do.
Kevin Butler! That's one guy whose expense reports I'm going to have to watch this week. But Kevin was right. PlayStation Move changes everything. It's why we believe the PlayStation Move is the device that will bridge the gap between core and casual, between hardcore gamers and people that have never picked up a controller. And motion gaming is the single biggest feature that non-PS3 owners are looking to see added to the PlayStation 3. So your wait is over. I'm happy to announce today the launch details for PlayStation Move. PlayStation Move will be available in Europe on September 15th, here in North America on September 19th, and in Japan on October 21st. And we'll have a couple different product offerings to get these into the homes. For those of you who already own a PlayStation 3 and the PlayStation Eye, the PlayStation Move motion controller will be available for $49.99. And the PlayStation Move navigation controller will sell for $29.99. Now, in addition, we'll offer a PlayStation Move bundle that will come with one Move motion controller, the PlayStation Eye, and our Sports Champions game, all for $99. And if you're one of those families I mentioned earlier that hasn't yet added the PS3 to your living room, we'll be offering a PlayStation Move PS3 bundle, including the PS3, the PlayStation Move controller, the PlayStation Eye camera, and Sports Champions, all for $399. Finally, we've priced our first-party PlayStation Move software lineup at $39.99 retail, and there'll be between 15 and 20 titles available on day one, with more than 40 titles available during the holiday selling season. The momentum for PlayStation Move is just beginning, and the biggest franchises are coming to PlayStation Move, including SOCOM 4, Time Crisis, Raging Storm, NBA 2K11, Ruse, Killzone 3, SingStar Dance, Echo Chrome 2, and iPad. And of course, there'll be a variety of titles currently on the market that will support PlayStation Move. For example, titles like Toy Story 3, Tiger Woods that you just saw a minute ago, Heavy Rain, and Resident Evil 5 Gold Edition. Each of these will have a software update that will enable PlayStation Move functionality. Now, before I pass it back to Jack, I'd like to conclude with a video that shows you what you can expect between now and December on PlayStation Move.
Thank you. As you can see, with both 3D experiences and PlayStation Move, the living room today isn't what it was 10 years ago or even 2 years ago. With PlayStation, the living room is no longer an actual space, it's a concept. When we talk about the digital living room, we don't mean the four walls in your home. We mean entertainment and content that follows you anywhere and everywhere. Central to that definition has been the PSP. In its sixth year, PSP remains the single best portable platform for gamers who are serious about games and unwilling to compromise the experience. We'll be driving the attention to this fact and getting the word out that PSP allows any serious gamer to step up your game. Today, we're kicking off a huge new campaign to support the PSP. These still are rough cuts, but I'd like you to be the first to see the new campaign that kicks off later this week.
Dear PlayStation, why aren't you talking about the PSP?
Actually,
these PSP games are the business, and I can't stand hearing these kids talking about some weak app on the phone.
Games, phone.
They're getting hustled, KB.
Hustled?
We need publicity for the PSP.
We're gonna do something about it.
PSP needs a hero.
Yeah.
A baller.
Yes.
Someone that ain't wearing a clip-on tie.
Huh?
We got good kids playing bad games.
You know what? You're onto something.
Mr. Butler's in the meeting right now. Can I take a message?
So tell me, Marcus, why are you qualified for this position?
You know, KB, thing about me is, I know the PSP.
All right, just a couple of questions here I gotta ask.
Fire away, KB.
What is your greatest strength?
Sniping.
Greatest weakness?
Work too hard, always running up the scoreboard.
How many games are there in the PSP library?
Over 500.
Name the best PSP game under $10.
SOCOM, Fireteam Bravo.
Favorite snack?
I consume a healthy amount of Suckers Online every day. Ah, like that answer.
When you first contacted me, I was just going to ignore you, but you showed me something today. You're hired. You start on Monday.
All right. Nice to know, my brother.
Okay, I'll see you Monday. I'll bring bagels.
Hi, Cindy. Can you bring bagels in on Monday?
Step your game up. Marcus, PSP.
PlayStation.
Dear PSP, I just scored the new Metal Gear Solid, and now I can't put it down.
So what's the problem?
I'm 40 hours in.
Whoa, now that's a work week. This ain't them little kiddie games your cousins play. This is a full-sized Metal Gear exclusive on your PSP.
I'm gonna finish it.
Much respect to you, dog. Other than the tie, the wrinkly shirt, and the lame job, I wanna be just like you one day. Step your game up, Marcus, PSP.
PlayStation.
Thank you. The core gaming experience on PSP starts with the industry's best portable gaming content. Last week, the Metal Gear Solid Entertainment Pack from Konami hit shelves. It's off to an incredible start. Kojima-san chose the PSP as the gamer's platform to bring this title to market. It's a perfect example of the only on PlayStation experience that we talk about. It's one of the many titles that make PSP the portable platform for gamers. The development pipeline for PSP is incredibly strong, and the new technologies and new gaming IPs will keep PSP going strong for years to come. An example of that technology is demonstrated with our upcoming title, Invisimals. Invisimals uses a PSP camera peripheral to provide an augmented reality experience to PSP. Using augmented reality in a full-featured handheld game opens up a whole new world of gaming possibilities on the PSP. Another exclusive PSP title is God of War: Chains of Olympus. Made by the same brilliant team at Ready at Dawn Studios, God of War: Ghosts of Sparta chronicles Kratos' rise to power. Here's a quick tease to whet your appetite.
Before there was a god, before there was a warrior, the Oracle had foretold of the Marked One. Every past has its ghosts. Every end must first begin.
In all, we'll be adding more of the industry's best franchises to the PSP this year, including Tron Evolution, the video game, Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep, Toy Story 3, Ace Combat: Joint Assault, the third birthday, UFC Unleashed 2010, and of course, from our worldwide studios group, God of War, Ghosts of Sparta, and Invisibles, both of which will be available bundled with hardware and PSP entertainment packs this fall. In total, there'll be more than 70 new titles coming to PSP by December. Let's take a look. PSP is a crucial part of our strategy to move beyond the living room to create a virtual, connected mobile entertainment experience. PSP allows you to access content on your PS3 from anywhere in the world. For no additional fee, consumers have a portable version of the content they rent or buy from the PlayStation Network. If you only really pay attention to our industry about once a year here at E3, you may be surprised at how far the PlayStation Network has come. We've seen a double-digit percent increase in connectivity among PS3 owners. PSN now has more than 50 million registered accounts in 58 countries around the world. In fact, PS3 is the most connected console on the market. It's that combination of great content and experiences that are fueling the growth and momentum behind the hardware sales. The PlayStation Network is the most comprehensive entertainment network out there. Last year, we even had our first original series with The Tester. It was an incredibly successful first season with more than 2.4 million views across the PSN and the PlayStation Home Theater. And I'm happy to announce that the casting call for The Tester Season 2 begins today. Details are available at thetester.com, and the second season will begin airing this fall. In addition, starting July 1st, we'll be launching our video delivery service in Canada. PlayStation Network has content from every major movie and television studio, from Showtime and HBO to Nickelodeon and NBC. PlayStation Network isn't just about the distribution of content. PlayStation Home is a great example of how we use this network to connect the content and experiences to the community. Home is a 3D social gaming network with over 100 games ready to play. and it's free for everyone who owns a PS3. In addition, for those of you who couldn't be here today, we replicated our booth completely in PlayStation Home, allowing the millions of PS3 owners across the globe to participate in E3. You can walk up to any kiosk in our booth, check out the videos, learn more about the products, or even get free exclusive home virtual items. That's something that can only be done on PlayStation. I invite everyone who couldn't be here this week to come and check it out. We've talked a lot about Sony innovation this morning, but let me turn now to the other pillar of PlayStation's strength, our content. If you look back at the past 15 years, we've designed the PlayStation ecosystem to benefit all of our partners. We've always focused on building the broadest tent possible across all genres and customers, from hardcore to family-friendly titles. We've challenged our publishing partners to invest in our platform because our platform has so much more to offer than any of our competition. There is one title that truly embodies that mentality, Little Big Planet. Little Big Planet merged consumer trends of user-generated content and social networking into a mashup genre called Play, Create, Share. Media Molecule was so critical to our vision for empowering gamer discovery and experience sharing that we acquired the company to ensure their ideas and genius will always be only on PlayStation. A few weeks ago, we brought another groundbreaking hit to the genre, one that redefined kart racing. In its first few weeks, Mod Nation Racers has already spawned more than 500,000 creations of tracks, karts, and mods. It's one of the most popular games on the PlayStation Network, and the best in this genre is yet to come. Here to show us Little Big Planet 2 from Media Molecule, please welcome Alex Evans.
Thank you very much. As you know, Little Big Planet was a very ambitious game for our small team. It focused on Sackboy playing through a simple platformer story which introduced the world to play, create, and share. So in Little Big Planet 2, we're staying true to that ethos of play, create, and share. But we're also, as you may have seen in the announcement trailer, massively expanding all of these areas, adding features like the Sackbot non-player characters, or character enhancements like the grapple hook, creative features from filmmaking tools to the six-axis direct control seat, as well as a load of new community and share features that integrate with the web. But in the end, all of this just comes down to one thing, making fun games. And now you can make any kind. It's a true platform for games. Whether you want to make an RTS, an RPG, a puzzle, a racing game, or even a shooter. So today we're going to focus on that breadth and the new competitive scoring modes, which we showcase how easy it is to bring competition into Little Big Planet. I'd like to show you, with the help of my friends here, some examples we've just picked out for you live on stage. First up, we have Super Block Race. This is a super simple dexterity minigame, and it stars our Sackboys racing to match the falling blocks by pressing the X and O face buttons. Using direct control, you can create any mapping from the six-axis controller to the gameplay. The time penalty for the getting a mistake is balanced by the creator, and it's actually hiding a great depth to the gameplay. It was a great way to create a simple piece of gameplay mechanic with just a few physical tools that you'll be familiar if you've ever used Pop-It in Little Big Planet 1. With the new competitive scoring, each player gets their own score, which can be set by the creator. And at the end of the level, here in 2 seconds, you get presented with a neat map so that the winner can celebrate in style. So next up, we have Crashy Crash. It's a kind of top-down sports sumo. And in this level, these guys are just trying to bump each other out of the ring. But what the creator's done here is add X and mapped it to give a boost, which adds an element of strategy. Again, it's a really simple game mechanic that was great fun to create using the physical tools. This level also showcases, for those creators out there, the mover objects, which allow you to attach them to any piece of the world and make it move exactly how you want, ranging from the central spawn point, which moves objects between layers, to any kind of motion that you can imagine. Once again, at the end of the level, you get a neat grid showing who did what to who and who's the ultimate winner. Lastly, I'd like to introduce you to the glorious chaos of multiplayer competitive action in this Rocket Arena level. This is actually the easiest one to build, simply placing objects in the world, setting gravity to low, and using a new character enhancement called the Creatinator. So players out there who've played LittleBigPlanet will be soaking up all of the new features here, but the Creatinator is a hat which you put on Sackboy and you can set to emit any object, from cows to flowers to rockets in this case. I think let's see who's doing the best. Come on, Green, you're on zero, nil point. Keep going. In the background, you see the holographic material. That's been used by many of our creators to create heads-up displays and things like that. In online, if you use a competitive mode, each PS3 gets its own camera, so it would be really easy to make a gigantic scrolling level in LittleBigPlanet 2. So to wrap up, I'd just like to show you some of footage of the kind of gameplay that you can expect in LittleBigPlanet 2. Because when we were creating these tools, really we wondered, what will the breadth be? We'll stay true to the platforming at the heart of LittleBigPlanet. So what we did was invite some of the top creators down to the Media Molecule offices, and we just gave them 24 hours to run wild with the new tools. We did not give them any tuition or any help. They'd seen nothing. And this is all unedited footage created in one night by some guys, ranging from a kind of gallery shooter here. Sackboy is doing way more than just platforming. There were tons of different kinds of levels, and we've carried this breadth all the way through to the story mode in LittleBigPlanet 2, ranging from top-down racing games with AI characters, and even, in one instance, a full real-time strategy game with multiple units, unit creation, pathfinding, psychedelic 3D shooter, which takes place at the end of one of the boss fights in the game. What you just saw was an example of the breadth of the in-game tools, the things that we use at Media Molecule and which our fans and our creators use also, ranging from custom HUDs to all of those features in the RTS. It's super easy and it looks beautiful. With LittleBigPlanet 2, the breadth and the possibilities are endless. You can make any kind of game you can imagine. It's truly a platform for games. Thank you for your attention.
Thanks, Alex. LittleBigPlanet is a perfect example of how we've worked to empower our customers through PlayStation Network. And we've been extremely pleased by the response. PlayStation Network delivers an unparalleled suite of services and entertainment, all for free. The service that the competition charges $50 for, PS3 users get absolutely free. And that's not going to change. For those customers who want to further enrich their experience, we've created a subscription package that will live on top of the currently available PlayStation Network offerings. The official name of this service package is PlayStation Plus. In addition to the current content and services that gamers get through the PSN, the PlayStation Plus provides PlayStation Network users with options to expand and enhance their gaming experience. PlayStation Plus subscribers will gain access to an exclusive set of features and content designed specifically for gamers. When you subscribe to PlayStation Plus, you'll get hundreds of dollars worth of value throughout the year, exclusive digital content from both our Worldwide Studios Group and our publishing partners. You'll get preferred early demos and priority invitations to select betas and free content ranging from full PSN games to themes and minis. You'll also get discounts on products on the PlayStation Store and a variety of other online services, such as automatic downloads that will push select demos, game-related videos, patches, and firmware updates to your PS3. It's a full product offering that will enable you to get more from PlayStation. PlayStation Plus will be available starting later this month for a full-year subscription for $49.99 or a three-month subscription for $17.99. In addition, for a limited time, we'll be offering 3 months free. Every month, we'll be adding new content and continually adding new features to make PlayStation Plus an incredible value offering. In its first month, PlayStation Plus will have the full PSN game, Wipeout HD, a title trial for Infamous, two PlayStation minis, Field Runners and Age of Zombies, and the PS1 classic Rallycross, as well as a variety of other downloadable content from avatars to DLC levels and map packs. This is content you will own for the duration of your subscription. Next month, in addition to a new PSN title, the new title trial, and even more downloadable content, PlayStation Plus will include Core, our high-definition interactive gaming lifestyle show. Again, you'll own that content for the duration of your subscription. We'll continually add new features and services to PlayStation Plus. In all, subscribers will get an unprecedented amount of value, access and convenience for just over $3 a month. PlayStation Plus is a great choice to help elevate your PlayStation gaming experience. Obviously, content will be a key driver for PlayStation Plus. And coming in 2010, content on the PlayStation 3 is stronger than it's ever been. By virtue of our success, the amount of exclusive content we're getting is going to be unmatched and will continue to grow. We're giving gamers more and more reasons not only to have a PlayStation 3, but to get the PlayStation 3 version of every big franchise out there. Not only are we seeing more mind-blowing creativity coming to our platform, we're seeing more partners seeking a deeper, more profound relationship with PlayStation, one that's designed to take advantage of all the aspects that PlayStation can provide, from PlayStation Move, 3D gaming, to PlayStation Network. Every step of the way, we're deepening our relationship with the publishing community. One of those brands which has been a driver for the industry and PlayStation platforms for the past 15 years is Electronic Arts. This year, EA is providing an unprecedented support for every one of the PlayStation initiatives we've been talking about today, including exclusive content, 3D, PlayStation Move, and PlayStation Network. To talk a bit more about what EA has in store for PlayStation fans this year, please welcome John Shepard.
Thanks, Jack. 15 years ago, EA and Sony locked arms for the launch of the PlayStation 1. And in the years that followed, we grew up together, pairing amazing games with amazing platforms. This evolved into one of the strongest relationships in the games industry, and arguably in entertainment. Today, I want to extend that tradition with two new titles featuring exclusive content just for the PlayStation 3. The first is Medal of Honor, a franchise born on PlayStation that became a global blockbuster on PS2. Yesterday, you saw multiplayer on PS3. Here today to unveil all new content is executive producer Greg Goodrich.
All right, thanks. Thanks a lot. Thanks, everyone. This year, Medal of Honor is moving out of World War II and placing gamers in the boots of today's soldier in war-torn Afghanistan. Authenticity and respect for the soldier have always been the core tenets of the Medal of Honor franchise. This title upholds that tradition. For the past 2 years, we have worked closely with the U.S. military and some of the world's most highly trained warriors in creating a truly authentic modern war experience. Today, we're revealing an all-new character. His name is Deuce, and he is a Tier 1 operator from AFO Wolfpack. Let's take a look.
We confirm 10 SIG INTs hits in the last 48 hours of fire from Gunfighter 6. We are 30 seconds out.
How's our imagery miss this shit? Can't see everything. That's why we're on the ground.
Ready to roll? Let's go to work, Deuce.
Thanks. All right, as you just saw on June 28th, we're going to unveil a series of videos where our Tier 1 operators, the very same guys that we've been working with on this game, well, they're going to share their experiences and their stories directly with you. All right, so the single player is being built by a veteran team right here in Los Angeles, and our multiplayer is being built by DICE, the world-class developers behind the Battlefield franchise. DICE gives us a rich multiplayer experience with realistic environments, tactical destruction, and weapons personalized through our weapon customization system. DICE also gives us unlockable beards. Absolutely. Yes, yes. I unlocked mine about 20 minutes ago. So, all right. So the partnership between EALA and DICE, we feel, will bring the absolute best in single and multiplayer to this game. So now I'd like to unveil an all-new multiplayer map that puts you on the ground in the Korangal Valley of Afghanistan. Check it out.
Make sure you get out of there before the JDAMs get dropped.
Roger, we have your grid. Missile away. Launch compressed. Stand by impact. Python 1, boss man. Target effect.
Enemy dug in on the hill. Trying to push up.
Copy that. Boss man, do you have eyes on Python?
Python 1 is hung up just at the base of the hill. Over.
Copy that.
Thanks, Greg. To reflect Medal of Honor's special relationship with PlayStation, we will offer a limited edition version of Medal of Honor exclusively for PlayStation 3 on October 12th. The limited edition will include a remastered high-definition version of the 2002 smash hit Medal of Honor Frontline. Two full games for just one price, only on PlayStation 3. Now, next up is Dead Space 2 for PlayStation 3. It's the sequel to one of the highest rated and best loved games this generation. With a live demo, here's executive producer Steve Papoutsis.
When we last left engineer Isaac Clarke, he was in deep space. Isaac was in the heat of battle on a huge space station called the Sprawl. After fighting his way through hordes of necromorphs, Isaac finds himself face to face with a horrific boss. Let's see what happens.
Thank you.
So that's Dead Space 2 by an awesome team at Visceral Games in Redwood Shores. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Steve. And today, I'm very proud to announce the Dead Space 2 limited edition pack for PlayStation 3. You get Dead Space 2 plus Dead Space Extraction now with PlayStation Move support. It's a great pack, exclusive for the PlayStation 3. So those are just two of the EA titles you'll see on PlayStation 3 this year. We're also working with Crytek to build a 3D version of Crysis 2, Tiger Woods PGA Tour with PlayStation Move support, and the entire portfolio of EA blockbusters like Madden, FIFA, NHL, Need for Speed. They all come alive on the PlayStation 3. The Sony EA partnership has never been stronger. We love the momentum we're seeing and the newly energized community of PS3 gamers. We're looking forward to another great year and another great chapter in the Sony EA partnerships. Thank you and have a great show.
Thanks, John. Our next guest has spent the better part of a decade developing some of the most critically acclaimed franchises, and we're really pleased to welcome to the stage for the first time.
Stand by for an important announcement from the Aperture Science Emergency Surprise System. Deploying surprise in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name is Gabe Newell, and I work at Valve. Now, I've been pretty outspoken in my comments about the current generation of game consoles. So I'd really like to thank everyone at Sony for their gracious hospitality and for not repeatedly punching me in the face. If I seem a little nervous, it's because Kevin Butler was introduced to me backstage as the VP of sharpening things. As an industry, we're going through a transition from entertainment as a product to entertainment as a service. And because of that, the needs of game players and game developers are evolving. More specifically, it's not just about chips for rendering pixels or calculating nav meshes. It's about giving gamers a complete, social, connected experience. By adopting an open approach to these challenges, the PlayStation 3 is going to excel in this area. So, I'm very pleased to announce that we'll be bringing Portal 2 to the PlayStation 3. I'm excited that Steam will be part of that experience, and I think that gamers will be delighted with features like Steam Cloud and automatic updates that will make the PlayStation 3 version of Portal 2 the best version on any console. So now, for the very first time, let's take a look at Portal 2.
It's been a long time. How have you been? Differences behind us. For science, you monster.
Thank you, Gabe. Valve has an incredible history in this industry, and it's very exciting that PlayStation owners will be seeing Portal 2 on PlayStation 3 next year. Last year on this stage, we announced a new title from one of the industry's most recognized and established franchises, Final Fantasy. Following the success of this generation's definitive RPG, Final Fantasy XIII, our friends at Square Enix have been hard at work on their new MMO. I'd like to show you a brief video of Final Fantasy XIV. Another great example of key publishing partner recognizing the opportunity and capitalizing on the momentum behind PS3 comes from 2K Games. Mafia 2 hits the shelf on August 24th, and we're excited to announce exclusive day one content that will be available only on PlayStation 3. Loads of new missions and hours of additional arcade-style gameplay will be available for free to those who purchase the PlayStation 3 version of Mafia 2. A title, thank you. A title we demonstrated on our stage last year came from our friends Ubisoft, who've been hard at work on their next chapter of their top franchise and expanding that universe with Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. Not only will you have the opportunity to play a full single-player campaign, but there'll be an exclusive package of missions that will only be available on PlayStation 3. In addition, for the first time, Assassin's Creed will introduce a unique, visceral multiplayer experience, and the multiplayer beta will only be available exclusively to PlayStation Network later this year. And here is the exclusive world premiere look at some of the multiplayer content.
For centuries, we have fought against the Assassins. Now, fellow Templars, we will win this war once and for all.
Exclusive has become my new favorite word. If you want to differentiate your product from your competition, you have to take advantage of each platform's strengths and create franchises with lasting power. In 2010, our publishing partners will prove time and time again that PlayStation 3 and PSP are their platforms of choice. There's a lot of content coming that we haven't been able to demonstrate to you on stage today, with titles like Metal Gear Solid Rising, Final Fantasy XIV, Mortal Kombat, Tron Evolution, the video game, Shaun White skateboarding, Call of Duty Black Ops, and DC Universe Online. It's shaping up to be another banner year. The content doesn't stop there, so let's take a look at a quick video that showcases some of the biggest titles coming to the platform. As you can see, the breadth and depth of content coming to PlayStation is stronger than it's ever been. If there's ever been a title that drives consumers to PlayStation 3, it's the next one. You saw a brief clip of Gran Turismo 5 earlier in stunning 3D. GT 5 has long been one of the industry's most anticipated titles, and we're about to finally get our hands on Polyphony's masterpiece. Let's take a look.
kilometer per hour on a straightaway.
When Gran Turismo 5 launches on November 2nd in North America and Latin America, it will be fully playable in 3D as well, with both gameplay modes on one Blu-ray disc. Last year, franchises like Uncharted, Assassin's Creed, and God of War demonstrated how teams are mastering the technology of PS3 to build sequels that are not just bigger and better, but raise the bar and break industry records. This level of evolution is the goal for our next developer as they craft their successor to their 2009 hit, Infamous. I'm pleased to show you a glimpse of the next mammoth Sucker Punch title, Infamous 2.
Choices I've made, or obstacles I've overcome. I continue to search for the life, a life that eludes me. But some shit never changes. Well, maybe some things. It is always something. We're reaching the home stretch, and we have one last surprise for you.
Where was the skill? Where was the strategy? I mean, shoot, drive, nothing.
Those games had both skill and strategy.
You're racing in a city, going 100 miles per hour, blasting everything as you go.
Speed, strategy, skill. Those games were awesome.
Maybe back in your day, sweetheart, but look, you name me one car combat game that was as good on PlayStation 1, kicked ass on PlayStation 2, and kicked even more ass on PS3. The ultimate ass kicking. Name it. That's right. You can't do it because it doesn't exist. Now get back to work, punk.
I'm the punk.
Don't kick my cab.
Punk.
everybody. I'm David Jaffe, and this is Scott Campbell, and we're the co-founders of Eat, Sleep, Play. And we're... Thank you. And we're really excited to show you guys the next edition of the Twisted Metal franchise. Now, Twisted Metal is the longest running series in PlayStation history. From PS1 to PS2 and onto the PSP, the multi-million selling Twisted Metal series has been there from the start.
And today we're excited to announce that the Twisted Metal legacy will continue, coming exclusively to PlayStation 3, 2011. Our new game, Twisted Metal, is being created by the same key members who gave birth to the dark humor and fast action gameplay of the classic Twisted Metal series.
So let's get a quick look at some gameplay from our online team deathmatch mode.
Scott, you're up.
Okay.
So, this is, Twisted has always occurred in backyards, in cities of our own reality. Here you see them totally trashing Main Street, tearing it apart. The classic deathmatch mode returns with 16 players online, along with 2- and 4-player online split screen, and plenty of new mode variations. As you can see, we've added flight to the series for the first time, allowing players to get a bird's eye view of the battle below. The advantages of flight are pretty obvious, but watch out for that sniper weapon. More depth has also been added to the weapons, giving each vehicle 2 special attacks. We've created team weapons that bring out the co-op nature of our team-based gameplay. As you just saw, the magnet special is good for carrying your teammates into or out of the battle zone. The twisted humor of the series is known for is back in both the gameplay and weapons, as well as with our characters and stories for our campaign mode. The piloted gurney weapon is deadly, so watch out. So that's a taste of Twisted Metal Team Deathmatch. We've got Dave here doing a sniper shot. We now want to show you one of our new game modes. It's our twisted take on objective-based team play.
Okay, so as Scott was saying, this is a new mode that's designed to really bring out the skill and strategy, class-based play a little bit, as well as team mode, Twisted Metal. It's called Nuke, and we'll show you a little bit of that in our rundown, dilapidated city environment. Now, this is a great level to show Nuke off in because there's a lot of gameplay design philosophies at work here. We have low-lying levels that become huge skyscrapers that you can start from bottom of the ground, fight your way to the top, and have rooftop combat. We've got a freeway system that connects the whole level together with moving traffic. We've got low-lying slums. We've got a big junkyard with a huge battle section in the middle. And then we also have these kind of rolling hills that kind of tie everything together in the center. Now, this is a great level for straight-up car combat, deathmatch, team deathmatch, variations on that mode that you'll be seeing. But it's great for Nuke as well. Now, online, Twisted Metal is all about factions fighting factions. And so in this demo, we have the Sweet Tooth faction, the Clowns, inspired by Sweet Tooth right here from Twisted Metal. And then we also have the Dolls, who are inspired by Dollface from Twisted Metal Black. And we'll have more factions to reveal throughout the year as we talk about the game. Now, what is the goal of Nuke? Well, if you look up, you see these giant statues being carried around by transport helicopters in the guise of the faction leaders. And you basically have to destroy your faction statue before they destroy yours. But obviously, these are huge, giant, you know, metal monsters, and how do you do it? Straight up weapons won't take them out. All right, so if you look at the rooftops, you'll notice a couple of the faction leaders. Here's Sweet Tooth, who's manning his gun turret. And across the map on the other side, we also have Dollface over here, and she's manning her turret too. And the goal of this mode is to capture the faction leader. And this is where team play begins to come into it, where basically if you run in and try to grab the leader, you're gonna lose a lot of health. You send your buddies in instead to weaken up the forces, the defenses, and then you're able to go in, as we'll see in a second, and grab the leader. And so now that you've got, in this case, Sweet Tooth being dragged behind your car, the question is, what do you do with this guy? So if you look around the level, you'll notice these missile launchers right here. And each faction has their own missile launcher. And so there's this perimeter you see, this yellow ring. If you can bring the faction leader into the yellow ring, into the perimeter, and keep him there long enough, you'll begin to charge up and bring the missile launcher to life. Now, teamwork, again, is crucial, because if you lose the faction leader in that perimeter, like capture the flag, it respawns back at base, and you got to go back and get him again. So if you can get a buddy to post up on top of a skyscraper with a sniper rifle, it's really effective at taking down the enemies. You can also send in vehicles that are really, really strong, like the motorcycles that have flaming chainsaws. They can take out bad guys in two or three hits. So in this case, we've charged up the missile launcher because we've kept the leader in there long enough. And now all that's left to do is basically sacrifice the leader to the missile launcher, and you will earn your faction a missile launch. So here he goes. Now he's in, and now you've earned the missile. Now what's left to do is you and your team have to guide that missile and protect it from helicopters and a variety of other attacks into the enemy statue. And the first team to hit the enemy statue 3 times wins nuke for their faction. So that's our nuke mode. We're really excited to meet with the press later in the week to talk about the mode and more of the depth and whatnot. Thank you for your time. Everything you saw and more from Team Deathmatch is playable starting now in the Sony booth. We look forward to seeing you there. Have a great show.
It's great to see Sweet Tooth making his debut on PS3. As David mentioned, you can play it in our booth right now. For 15 years, the two pillars of PlayStation's strength has been its innovation and its content. We're on the verge today of a future unlike any in the previous 15 years. 4 years into our life cycle, PS3 continues to evolve, and our commitment to content and innovation is unwavering. With 3D, Move, PlayStation Network, and exclusive content from the industry's best developers taking us to a place where nobody else in this industry can go, we're delighted that all of you are along with us for the ride. Our secret weapon today, as it's always been, are the loyal PlayStation fans. We thank you for being our partners, our allies, and our friends in this industry, and we look forward to writing a whole new chapter together. Thank you very much.